tuan-tuan dan puan-puan sekalian, perbarisan masuk kontingen-kontingen nasional negara-negara peserta Kuala Lumpur 98, Sukan Commonwealth ke-16 dan kontingen sukarelawan-sukarelawan.
Ladies and gentlemen, now the marching in of the national contingents of participating nations of Kuala Lumpur 98, the 16th Commonwealth Games, and the contingent of volunteers. The marching in is led by the Joint Brass Band of the Army, the Royal Malaysian Navy, the Royal Malay Air Force, and the Royal Malaysian Police Force, under the direction of Drum Major DSP Abu Bakar Long, and assisted by Captain Jaafar Yusof.
Tuan-tuan dan puan-puan sekalian, negara-negara peserta Kuala Lumpur 98 Sukan Commonwealth ke-17.
Ladies and gentlemen, the participating nations of Kuala Lumpur 98, the 16th Commonwealth Games.
Canada, Anglia, Antigua and Barbuda. Barbados, Belize, Bermuda.
Botswana, the British Virgin Islands, Brunei Darussalam.
Cameroon, the Cayman Islands, the Cook Islands. Islands, Fiji, Gambia,
Ghana, Gibraltar, Grenada,
Guernsey, Guyana, India. Kenya, Kiribati, Lesotho,
Malawi, Maldives, Malta,
Mauritius, Montserrat, Mozambique. The Norfolk Islands, Northern Ireland, Pakistan,
Papua New Guinea, Samoa, Scotland,
Seychelles, Sierra Leone, Singapore, St. Helena, St. Kitts and Nevis, St. Lucia,
Maldives, Swaziland, Tanzania,
Tonga, Trinidad and Tobago, Turks and Caicos Islands,
Tuvalu, Uganda, Vanuatu,
Wales, Zambia, Zimbabwe, Dua-dua nombor sekian, negara tuan rumah pada nombor 98, Sukan Kabupaten 16, Malaysia! Sukarelawan, sukarelawan, Kuala Lumpur 98, Sukan Kabupaten 16, Nadi 98.
Thank you. centre. Lines up in their nations. They won't be like that for much longer, I don't think.
Mencatatkan rekod terbaru dalam sejarah Sukan Commonwealth, di mana terdapat bilangan terbesar negara-negara peserta di kejohanan Sukan Commonwealth yang terakhir pada abad ke-20 ini.
Ladies and gentlemen, the gathering of 70 nations at this Carnival of Sporting Excellence has indeed broken a new record in the Commonwealth Games history, with the biggest country participation ever, and as the last Commonwealth Games of the 20th century.
Seterusnya, upacara penyerahan kembali bendera-bendera nasional negara-negara peserta Kuala Lumpur 98 Sukan Commonwealth ke-16. Dijemput pemegang-pemegang bendera negara-negara peserta mengambil tempat untuk penyempurnaan acara.
And now, the flag bearers of the participating nations of Kuala Lumpur 98 and 16 Commonwealth Games will take their places at the Tribune of Honour for the return of the National Flag Ceremony.
So Susie O'Neill now will take the Australian flag to the Tribune of Honour.
Interesting to see as well, David, that the 17-year-old Mark Kelly from the Isle of Man, who rode in the track here, he will also be carrying it for the island. And there's Susie as she joins in now, as she carries the flag. Proud moment, and what an athlete. As Perkins, sorry David, as Kieran Perkins carried the flag at the opening ceremony, with who else could it have been but Susie O'Neill of Australia, another swimmer of course, to carry it at the closing.
Remarkable athlete. She thought about retiring in 1992 and then again in 1994. She won the gold medal in the 200 metres butterfly in Atlanta, and now 6 gold medals in the 1 Games.
Susie looking around to make sure she's doing the right thing here. It's not often you get to do this in front of 100,000 people. All of the nations now, all 70 of them, half of them winning medals here. All of them friendly as they were before the games began, as they are now at the finish. Barry Ford, the Barbados cyclist who carries the flag for Barbados. They were telling me the other day he's an absolute national hero back home now.
Nicole, who won the men's individual squash tournament on debut here at the Commonwealth Games, carries the flag for Scotland.
President Persatuan Sukan Commonwealth berangkat President Majlis Olimpik Malaysia yang berbahagia Tan Sri Hamzah Abu Sama.
The President of the Commonwealth Games Association and President of the Olympic Council of Malaysia, Tan Sri Hamzah Abu Sama, will now declare the return of the flags.
The chairman of the Commonwealth Games Association of Malaysia, I hand back to you the flag of your country, both in token of our friendship and goodwill towards you, and as a memento of the 16th Commonwealth Games, Kuala Lumpur, 1998.
Terima kasih.
Thank you.
Perbarisan masuk pegawai-pegawai kadet laut dan relawan Diraja Malaysia diketuai oleh pegawai kadet laut Karan Syarudin Bumsu.
The marching in of the midshipmen of the Royal Malaysian Navy, led by senior midshipman Syarudin Bumsu.
So what a moment for the 70 athletes who now receive their nation's flag and a memento that they will treasure forever.
Marching on now, the Royal Malaysian Navy, all of the armed forces have the part to play here. And there is Susie O'Neill as she watches as the proceeds continue.
And we'll be back in Kuala Lumpur in just a moment.
Tuan-tuan dan puan-puan sekalian, upacara menurunkan bendera Persekutuan Sukan Commonwealth diiringi nyanyian lagu rasmi Kuala Lumpur 98 Sukan Commonwealth ke-16 Bersama Selamanya.
Ladies and gentlemen, the lowering of the Commonwealth Games Federation ceremonial flag, accompanied by the singing of the official song of Kuala Lumpur 98, the 16th Commonwealth Games, forever as one.
Welcome back for the crescendo of the closing ceremony of the Commonwealth Games.
The most emotional moment, the lowering of the Commonwealth flag, a sign to everyone that these games are at an end. The athletes gaze blankly at the flag as it comes down, and the goodness knows what goes through their mind after 11 days of competition.
Perarakan bendera Persekutuan Sukan Commonwealth mengelilingi Stadium Nasional Bukit Jalil diiringi pacar agam tambur dan serunai dari batalion kelima Rajaman Askar Melayu Diraja
batalion Rajaman
Ranger Diraja dan polis Diraja Malaysia di bawah pimpinan Sarjan Zulkifli Muhammad Yusof.
And for athletes at the end of their careers, this will be a sad moment for the younger ones. They will look forward to major championships to come, and of course the 17th edition of the Commonwealth Games in Manchester in 4 years' time.
Once again, as they troop the flag around the stadium, the pipes and drums from the 5th Battalion of the Royal Malay Regiment, the 6th Battalion of the Royal Ranger Regiment, and the Royal Malaysian Police Force will accompany them under the direction of Sergeant Zulkifli Muhammad Yusof. Prince Edward, welcomed and announced the opening of these games, bringing the message from his mother, the Queen, and ready here in the famous Royal Baton. And today, earlier, we saw Prince Edward in Albert Square in Manchester, where he was welcoming everybody to Manchester in 4 years' time. Respective country lines within the centre of the stadium, carrying the flags of the nations, all 70 of them. Pipes and drums steadily, only just about past the 100 metre point around the circle.
I feel down to where the athletes are sitting at the end of the straight as we watch the ceremonial flag. You do get the feeling that they're ready to burst onto the arena, as usually happens at the end of a major championship.
I can see, David, the Mexican wave has started just behind what you were saying there. Why shouldn't they? This is now time to release the steam after many, many months of preparation. There they are. Looking a little bit calm just now, the Malaysians in amongst them there. Scottish athletes as well.
It's almost a tradition at the end of the Commonwealth Games that the athletes burst onto the arena and they're getting just a fraction itchy. They want to be a part of the celebrations.
The question of who makes the first move, I think. Scotland.
Peter Nicol, who won the individual title in the squash. More of the athletes who are becoming more and more edgy as time goes on.
Which one will go first, because the rest will surely follow. Meanwhile, the pipes and drums are headed into the 200 metres to go point.
Of course, as is customary, the flag will be handed to the custody of the next host, Manchester, whose preparations will now begin in earnest. We've had a big crew here watching and observing and learning from what the Malaysians have done. They've set a high standard. There's Tanya Van here in the centre of the screen with Debbie Edwards on her left and Denise Passmore. What a night it was for Tanya. Two gold medals.
Absolutely. What a day it was all day today for them.
She led home the women's 4x400 metre relay team. She ran the opening leg of the sprint relay to go with her bronze medal in the 100 metres.
She's still there with a number on.
Have a treasure trove in her bag. She'll go home tonight with two goals from the Commonwealth Games.
Now the flag party arrive. They will present the flag back to the Commonwealth Games Federation, who in turn will offer it to Kuala Lumpur to offer it on to Manchester.
Penyerahan bendera persekutuan Sukan Commonwealth kepada pemeru senior Cik Michael Fennell. Beliau akan menyerahkan bendera kepada Datuk Bandar Kuala Lumpur yang berbahagia Tan Sri Kamal Zaman Sharif, dan seterusnya akan diserahkan pula kepada Councillor Gordon Conquest, Datuk Bandar Bandaraya Manchester, England, mewakili tuan rumah Sukan Commonwealth ke-17 tahun 2002.
The ceremonial flag will be presented to the Chairman of the Commonwealth Games Federation, Mr. Michael Fennell, who in turn will present it to the Mayor of Kuala Lumpur, Tan Sri Kamal Zaman Sharif. The flag will then be handed over to Councillor Gordon Conquest, Lord Mayor of the City of Manchester, England, host city of the 17th Commonwealth Games in the year 2002.
Manchester, England, the host in 2002, and the English team here had a good championship, 36 gold medals. They dominated in the track, 10 gold medals there. They won 3 in badminton, 4 in boxing, 3 in the artistic gymnastics for 135 medals overall. They finished second on the medal tally behind Australia, an improvement on 4 years ago where they were third to the host nation in Canada. And I'm sure as the president of the Commonwealth Games Federation, Michael Fennell, receives the flag, we'll be looking forward to success in Manchester in 2002.
Mayor of Kuala Lumpur, as chairman of the Commonwealth Games Federation, I entrust this ceremonial flag to your care, and I ask that you deliver it to the Lord Mayor of Manchester, which city will be the host of the 17th Commonwealth Games in 2002.
Hardly seems 4 years since Canada was going through this and passing it on to Kuala Lumpur. Lord Mayor of Manchester will receive it.
And of course, all Australians hope in 4 years' time that the Mayor of Manchester will pass over the Commonwealth Games flag to the Mayor of Melbourne.
And now the marching out of the midshipmen from the Royal Malaysian Navy, accompanied by the pipes and drums band.